friends in Christ, what is the message God wishes to give us today on the Feast of the Conversion of St. Paul? The scriptures tell us to have holy zeal for Jesus and his gospel. With holy zeal, pursue the cause of respect for the life of the unborn child. This is what our friend St. Paul teaches us today on his feast day, holy zeal for Jesus and his gospel. St. Paul, before his conversion to Jesus, pursued the cause of persecuting Christians with zeal. But God did not bless his zeal. It seems like it was the cause more of Saul of Tarsus, but it was not God's cause that he was pursuing. What was missing? What was missing from Saul of Tarsus was love and humility. Saul of Tarsus was not humble. He was proud and arrogant, and therefore God did not bless his work. Saul of Tarsus also did not know the love of God through Jesus. He persecuted with hatred the followers of Jesus to death and delivered them to prison. Therefore, God was absent from Saul's work. He thought he was doing the Lord's work, but God did not bless his work. Saul did not realize it, but God was pursuing Saul even more fiercely than Saul was pursuing Christians. And God overtook Saul and conquered him by a love that Saul had never experienced before. Brothers and sisters, God is also fiercely pursuing the culture of death in order to conquer it with his love. We know that there are people on the other side who are absolutely convinced that what they are doing is right, as was Saul of Tarsus in his own time, absolutely convinced. But God knows what graces can be showered down from heaven, even on the most hardened of hearts, in answer to our prayers, in answer to our prayer vigils, our fasting, our days of abstinence, our loving outreach to those considering abortion, our works of mercy, public witness, and involvement in the public discussion. He can change the most hardened of hearts. And Paul is proof of that. If we look at him before and after discovering the love of Jesus. My brothers and sisters, you know this year we are involved in a nationwide call to prayer for life, marriage, and religious liberty, made up of five parts. A Eucharistic Holy Hour for this intention each month in your parish. A daily family rosary for this intention. Special prayers of the faithful at all masses, Sundays and weekdays. Fasting and abstinence on Fridays. A second observance of a fortnight for freedom in June and July of this year. Please work with your pastors to implement this national call to prayer in your parishes, because what we wish to do is to pursue the culture of death and overcome it with God's love and his graces. Today's feast of the conversion of St. Paul is is a great lesson and encouragement for us in the power of God's grace to change hearts. He can do it. St. Paul the Apostle, pray for us to have a holy zeal for Jesus and his gospel, and to be unwavering in our love for Jesus, a love which impels us to bring our Savior's message to others. Go out to all the world